हेलो एंड वेलकम बैक टू आवर चैनल स्टैट्स एंड फिजिक्स कॉन्सेप्ट्स बाय मिस्टर हेमंत। सो दिस इज़ आवर सिक्स्थ लेक्चर इन फिजिक्स एंड अगेन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट प्रोजेक्टाइल मोशन। सो इन आवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स ऑल्सो वी हैव कवर्ड दिस टॉपिक प्रोजेक्टाइल मोशन। सो वील बी एनालाइजिंग one more example in this topic, so you can see what the problem is. The problem is, show that for a projectile motion the angle between the velocity and the x-axis is a function of time. So for a projectile motion the angle between the velocity and the x-axis, so you have fired a projectile making some angle with respect to the x-axis, and we are saying that angle changes with respect to time. So it is a function of time, means that angle is changing with respect to time and is given by theta t. So this is not a multiplication, theta is a function of time. Function of time means the angle theta will vary or it will change with respect to time. This is given by theta t equal to tan inverse v dash y minus gt upon v dash x. So what is v dash y here? You can see this is the initial vertical velocity of the projectile. V dash x is the horizontal velocity of the projectile. Now you can see here in this formula itself gives you some information that how this theta is varying. You can see here, this is constant, v dash x in a projectile motion. This I discussed earlier also, that since there is no opposing force acting in the horizontal direction, therefore v dash x, this will remain the same throughout the projectile motion. What about v dash y? This, the vertical component of the velocity will be changing both the ways. While the projectile is moving in upper direction, reaches the maximum height, then when again it starts moving downward from maximum height to ground. So in both the cases, whether the projectile goes upward or it goes downward, the velocity, vertical component of the velocity, it changes. So as time increases, suppose a projectile is going in upward direction and you are this t component, so time is increasing in that case. So this factor, it gets subtracted from this v dash y. So what happens if this whole value gets reduced? So you'll get a lower value of this theta. So you'll get a lower value of theta. It means when the projectile is going in upward direction and the time is increasing, what is happening to this theta? Theta will keep on decreasing, and when the projectile moves in downward direction from the maximum height to the some point to some point on ground, then what is happening to theta in that case? Theta will keep on increasing. So we'll analyze this, how we can do this problem. Again, this is x, this y. So this is the trajectory or the path traveled by our projectile motion. Sorry, projectile. Let us say this is the velocity with which the shell was fired. Let me take this as V. So this is V is the velocity of projectile. यू कैन टेक एनी थिंग है, इट मे बी अ शेल फायर्ड फ्रॉम अ गन और फ्रॉम अ कैनन, समथिंग लाइक दिस. दिस इज द एंगल थीटा. सो द प्रोजेक्टाइल मेक सम एंगल विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू एक्स एक्सिस, दैट एंगल इज थीटा. And we discussed this earlier also. G is acting downward. Unit vector I, unit vector J. So unit vector I is in the direction of, so in the direction of x axis we take unit vector I. So in the direction of y axis we take unit vector J. Now what they are saying, you can see here, if I take different points here, on this trajectory path, you can see what is happening to this angle. You can clearly see what is happening to the angle theta. It is decreasing. So it keeps on decreasing, decreasing, and finally it becomes zero over here at this point. So you can see, if I take, draw one more line here, you can see with respect to horizontal axis theta 2. So you can see here theta 2 is less than theta 1, theta 1 is less than theta. So what is happening to the angle? The angle made by velocity of the projectile with respect to x axis keeps on decreasing. So it keeps on decreasing when the projectile is moving in upward direction. You have to specify this thing, because it won't be decreasing when the projectile moves from this highest point to at some point on ground. Let me take this as O, again this as M, this as L. Now come to this equation which they have given you. We have to show that this angle is theta. It is a function of time, means as it depends on time. So when time changes, this angle theta will also change. So let me draw the components here for this velocity vector. Let me take this as Vy dash, and this horizontal component as V dash x. So for more clarity, I can draw it here. So this is V velocity of the shell. This is the horizontal velocity of the shell. And this is the vertical velocity of the shell. So I can take any two points here. One is this one. One is this point, and there is this point. Let me take this as a point T, and let me take this point as Q. So I can take this as a VY double dash. V double dash Y. Let me say this has the final vertical velocity at point. So this I have taken as Q. Now I can relate the final vertical velocity. I can relate the final vertical velocity with its initial वर्टिकल वेलोसिटी बाय यूजिंग दिस फॉर्मूला. वी इज इक्वल टू यू प्लस जी टी, दैट सिंपल फॉर्मूला है. सो वी इक्वल टू वी डबल डैश वाई, दिस इज इक्वल टू वी डैश वाई माइनस जी टी. ओके, दिस इज वॉट वी गेट. वॉट अबाउट द हॉरिजॉन्टल वेलोसिटी? सो वी एक्स रिमेन्स कॉन्स्टेंट. दिस आई एक्सप्लेन यू, दिस वी एक्स, यू कैन कॉल दिस एज वी डैश एक्स. दिस वी डैश एक्स, दिस विल रिमेन सेम थ्रू आउट. This will remain same throughout because there is no force acting on this projectile in horizontal direction. So only your vertical component gets affected. So let us take this angle as theta, this given. So draw this parallel to this. This becomes V dash Y. Now if you find out tan theta here, what do you get? V dash Y upon V dash X. So let us write it here. So tan theta is V dash Y by V dash X, or let me take with respect to this, so that I can consider this as initial velocity. This is the final velocity. So I've drawn this with respect to this second point Q, and the initial point was T. So V double dash Y, and this is V dash X. So what is tan theta now? Tan theta, this is given by V double dash Y upon V dash X. Let me call this as equation 2, or I can write this as theta equal to tan inverse V double dash Y by V dash X. And what is V double dash Y? V double dash Y, it is given by V dash Y minus GT. So let me put this over here. Tan inverse V dash Y minus GT upon V dash X. So this is theta. So this is the final equation we get. So you can see this. This is similar to the one which is given here. This we discussed in our previous lecture also, that why we are taking this sign as negative, because you can see this G is acting downward, so in the downward direction. That is why, because of this, we have taken this as minus G. You may please refer to my previous lectures also, where I have used this vector notation to explain all these formulas. So this was the first part. Now what is the second part of this problem? They are saying, show that the projection angle theta naught for a projectile launched from the origin is given by theta naught equal to tan inverse 4hm by r. So we have to show this thing now. Now again, look at this problem. This also we have discussed in our previous lectures, that how we can find out this theta. We calculated the maximum height attained by the projectile. Also, we calculated formulas for finding the range of the projectile. So if I talk about h maximum, it is given by u square sine square theta upon 2g, and the range is given by u square sine 2 theta upon g. These are the two equations we have derived already earlier in our previous lectures. So what we have to find out, this we have to relate this maximum height attained by the projectile, range, and this angle theta. So we have to relate these three things. So what I can do, I can insert the value of this u square in this equation, in the first one. So I can write here inserting the value of u square from equation 2 in equation 1. So this is what we can do. So what you have from here, you have u square range, this is equal to u square sine 2 theta upon g, or I can write u square equal to, this will be range into g upon sine 2 theta. This is what we get. So this is the value for u square. Now let us put this u square value where? In this h maximum equation. So I can write h max, this is equal to range into g upon sine 2 theta into sine square theta upon 2g. This is what we have. So this is the value that we get. Now again simplify it. So h max, this will be equal to range, I can write as r into g into sine theta upon sine 2 theta, can be written as 2 sine theta cos theta into 2g. So this g gets cancelled, this sine theta it gets cancelled. So what we are left with, we get sine theta by cos theta, that is tan theta. So we get h max, this is equal to r sine theta by cos theta, that is tan theta upon 2 into 2, 4. This is what we get. So further, we can solve this. So we have obtained this equation h max equal to r tan theta upon 4. Let me call this equation as equation number 3. So we get tan theta, that is equal to 4 h max upon r, or theta equal to tan inverse 4 h max upon r. This is the ultimate equation we have obtained now. So you can see here theta naught, this is equal to tan inverse 4hm by r, and we have obtained this theta equal to tan inverse 4h max by r. So we can again quickly review the things what we have done. So you can see here the problem was we have to show that in case of a projectile motion, the angle theta which the projectile makes with respect to the x-axis, that is a function of time, means it changes with time. So we have discussed this with the help of this figure. You can see here, this is the projectile which is fired initially with velocity v, and it makes an angle theta with respect to the ground. At any point it has got two components. One is the horizontal component that we took as v dash x, vertical component v dash y. So if I compare this and another point here, then the final velocity, since it changes after some time, the final velocity we have taken as v double dash y. Initial velocity we took, this is similar to v dash x only, the same horizontal velocity. And then we have made use of these vectors to calculate the angle here, this tan theta. Now you can see here that as the projectile is going in upward direction, what is happening to the angle theta here? It is decreasing, and at this point it becomes almost zero. Then again it will start increasing when it starts moving from the highest point to the ground. This is what I have shown. So this angle theta 2 is less than theta 1, and theta 1 is less than theta. Then we are making use of this simple formula, v is equal to u plus at, the first equation of motion. So here I am putting it in the form of this g. So v double dash y, that is the final vertical velocity. This will be equal to initial vertical velocity v dash y minus gt. Then we calculated this tan theta here. Tan theta is v double dash y upon v dash x. This, then putting the value of v double dash y, which is equal to v dash y minus gt. So put the value here, so you get theta equal to tan inverse of this. So this was our first equation we obtained. And for the second part of the problem, we need to calculate the, we need to relate theta with h max and range. So h max is given by u square sine square theta by 2g. So this was the problem. So for the second part of the problem, we need to relate this theta, the angle which projectile makes with respect to x-axis, with that of maximum height attained and the range of the projectile. So we know the formula for maximum height attained by the projectile, u square sine square theta by 2g, and the range is given by u square sine 2 theta by g. Then by substituting the value of u square in this first one, you can solve this, and ultimately you will get h max is equal to r tan theta by 4. This I've shown you the whole calculation. So we have obtained here this theta equal to tan inverse 4h max by r. So with this we'll stop here, and we'll be coming with a few more topics in our coming lectures. So this is my channel, Stats and Physics Concepts by Mr. Hemant. You can subscribe to my channel, so that whenever we come up with more interesting and informative topics, you will be benefited by it. This is my email ID also. You can see stats5.hemant@gmail.com. So if you have any doubt regarding these topics we are covering in our lectures, you may please approach me at this email ID. Okay, so we'll do this much here. Okay, thank you. Thanks a lot.